By faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and happy Tuesday to you. I'm Clint Davis, the pastor of Chester ARP Church. Thank you for joining us for the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. Continuing in our reading of Luke chapter 8, we pick it up in verse 22, a familiar story to you. One day, he, that being Jesus, got into a boat with his disciples and said to them, "Let us go across to the other side of the lake." So they set out, and as they sailed, he fell asleep. And a windstorm came down on the lake, and they were filling with water and were in danger. And they went and woke him, saying, "Master, Master, we are perishing." And he awoke and rebuked the wind and the raging waves, and they ceased. And there was a calm. And he said to them, "Where is your faith?" And they were afraid, and they marveled, saying to one another, "Who then is this that he commands even the winds and the water, and they obey him?" Then they sailed to the country of the Gerasenes, which is opposite Galilee. When Jesus had stepped out on the land, there he met him, a man from the city who had demons. For a long time he had worn no clothes and had not lived in a house but among the tombs. And when he saw Jesus, he cried out and fell down before him with a loud voice. "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I beg you, do not torment me." For he had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man. For many a time it had seized him. He was kept under guard and bound with chains and shackles, but he would break the bonds and be driven by the demon into the desert. And Jesus asked him, "What is your name?" And he said, "Legion," for many demons had entered him. And they begged him not to command them to depart into the abyss. Now a large herd of pigs was feeding there on the hillside, and they begged him to let them enter these. So he gave them permission. Then the demons came out of the man and entered the pigs, and the herd rushed down the steep bank and into the lake and drowned. When the herdsmen saw what had happened, they fled and told it in the city and in the country. Then the people went out to see what had happened, and when they saw Jesus, they found the man from whom the demons had gone sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid. And those who had seen it told them how the demon-possessed man had been healed. Then all the people surrounding the country of the Gerasenes asked him to depart from them, for they were seized with great fear. So he got into the boat, and he returned. The man from whom the demons had gone begged that he might be with him. But Jesus sent him away, saying, "Return to your home and declare how much God has done for you." And he went away, proclaiming throughout the whole city how much Jesus had done for him. Now I read two fairly lengthy stories to us this morning from Luke chapter 8. The first is a story of how Jesus was on the sea with his disciples in a boat when a great storm came up. He was asleep because he was at peace. They were afraid. They woke him up. Jesus rebuked the wind and the waves and then questioned them where their faith was. The second story was a story of how Jesus cast out demons from a demon-possessed man who was living among the tombs, who was uncontrollable and wild. And once Jesus cast the demons out into the pigs, they went into the sea and they were drowned. The demon-possessed man found himself sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and ready to be at the service of the Lord. The people who of the town saw what had happened were afraid of Jesus and his power and asked him to leave. Just a few observations. Number one, Jesus has power over the wind and the waves, power over the demons. Jesus demonstrates his power. There is nothing that can overpower the Lord Jesus Christ. That's an important point with reference to these stories of healing. Jesus demonstrates his power. There's nothing in your life that can overcome him. He is great and greatly to be praised. He is all powerful. He has risen from the dead. Second thing is that he has the power to transform lives. He cast out demons. This man went from being naked and wild and running around to being clothed and seated and ready to serve. Jesus has the power to transform lives. Even the craziest and wildest lives can be tamed by Christ. And then the third thing is, Jesus told the man who wanted to go serve him to go and serve his family, to go home and serve his family and to proclaim of the excellencies of Jesus, tell of what Jesus has done. And the fourth thing, the people were afraid. You see, when Jesus comes into the world, we think that we'll be really excited about what Jesus is going to do in our lives. But sometimes the power of Christ, the power of Jesus, can terrify us. And so the people asked Jesus to leave, and he left. What a tragic request. And he honored it. Let me ask you, friends, do you want Jesus to stay in your life? Do you want him to work in your life? Do you want him to lurk around you? That's the question these passages challenge us with. It challenges, do you trust him to be powerful? Will you allow him to transform your life? And do you want him to stay nearby? You guys have a great day. God bless you. Answer those questions in your heart. Take care. I'll see you tomorrow.